Thank you for choosing this video. Unlike the regular tutorial videos, which monologue the features of a technology and leave it to the imagination of the viewers about where to apply those features in business. This video series walks you end-to-end, from an architect's point of view, about choosing a technology that addresses the current business needs and meets the architectural standards of an enterprise. Fasten your seatbelts and enjoy the technical conversation. It's a dialogue between an enterprise solution architect and an imaginary Kafka system. In this context, our architect is responsible for building a stream analytics solution for his organization. The organization has several types of business applications in its enterprise. These applications, in their current state, perform batch mode analytics on in-house data repositories. The organization has made a decision to add streams as a data source for these applications and expand the scope of their business analytics from batch mode to real time. The solution has to solve the long-term purpose while addressing the immediate need. From that perspective, architect is trying to understand how Kafka can help in building a stream processing layer that meets the best practices and patterns of an enterprise architecture.
Hello. My name is Brian. I'm a solution architect at the organization XYZ. We've several business applications in our enterprise landscape. These applications keep generating messages at various events, like web clicks, device readings, transaction alerts, and system logs. The messages generated during these events have very short lifetime, which means that if these messages are not consumed immediately, they will never be available to the downstream applications. I need to build a solution that makes this data available for the downstream applications when they need it. I've evaluated some stream processing frameworks in this regard and found that they are not meeting the requirements in total. I'm trying to understand how Kafka can address the technical needs of the solution that I'm thinking about. First step in building this solution is to create a storage layer that holds the messages. Let me find it out from Kafka how it addresses the storage needs of my solution. My first requirement is persistence. The intermittent storage layer needs to physically store the messages. It should not be just in memory storage nor on some temporary buffers. It has to put the messages on some physical storage medium.
Kafka persists your messages on physical storage. You create a producer record for each message and send it to Kafka using a producer object. Kafka stores these messages on disk in the form of a data file.
The message formats generated by these events are not unique. Each event type has a different message format. Some are JSON objects, some are plain texts, and some in the form of an array. The solution needs to support multiple message formats.
You can pass your custom object as a value type to the producer record. If you can represent the source message as a serializable object, you can use Kafka to store any message format.
Our message store needs some level of modularity. If all messages are stored under one header, it will not be possible to manage the authorization of downstream applications. Nevertheless, it increases the search complexity.
You can logically organize the messages into different topics. Specify the topic while sending the message to Kafka using producer class. You can control the authorizations at topic level.
We cannot upfront estimate message traffic or the count of messages we are going to receive under each topic. Maximum topic size should not be limited by the quantity of resources available on an individual node. Storage has to be physically distributed inside the cluster, so that the storage capacity can be scaled when required.
Topic is stored in a distributed fashion inside the cluster. A topic is divided into multiple partitions. Partitions are distributed across the machines available in the cluster. A partition can be replicated but cannot be split between two machines. You can specify to which partition a message should get into.
We cannot rely on the individual physical machines, which are used to store the partitions. These machines may fail at any point of time. But, our solution needs to be reliable. The message data should be available with our solution, even when there is a machine failure. The downstream applications should be able to depend on our solution to read the data, even when some of the machines in the storage layer fail.
Partitions are replicated to increase the reliability. You can specify the number of replications you want for each partition. The first replication will be the leader replica, and the rest are follower replicas. Each replica is stored on a different machine. If the node or disk of the leader replica fails, the downstream applications can still rely on your storage layer, because the data from one of the follower replicas will be made available to the downstream applications.
In some of the scenarios, the data read by the downstream applications must be consistent. Any data inconsistency between those applications could lead to wrong results. Our inventory management system and revenue monitoring systems are planned to use the data stream coming from point of sale system. If the data is inconsistent between these two applications, that may trigger an unnecessary fraud alarm. The failover incidents may occur at any point of time, while writing or reading the messages in the storage layer. Any delay in the replication mechanism should not make data inconsistent for the downstream applications.
You can implement a write strategy in which the producer waits for all the follower replicas of the partition to be synchronized with the leader replica. Only then the message write is considered as complete. However, this increases the write latency of the upstream applications.
For some of our applications, performance is more important than data consistency. Our product recommendation engine is planned to read the messages from our shopping portal. It recommends new products to the user based on the items added to the shopping cart. If these recommendations arrive late, they are of no use. Even if the recommendations are occasionally inconsistent, they always need to arrive quickly at the shopping website. These sort of applications can afford to be temporarily inconsistent. But the write performance needs to be very high. So, the storage layer should support multiple write strategies. One for data consistency, as discussed earlier, and one for low latency.
For these applications, you can implement a write strategy in which the producer writes the messages asynchronously to the Kafka cluster and returns immediately without waiting for the partition replications to complete.
We have some producer applications that record the position of a moving vehicle, record the readings from a medical sensor, and record the sequence of fund transfers in a purchase transaction. For these data streams, the order of a message is as important as the content of the message. If the order changes, the message has no meaning. It becomes void or unusable. The solution has to protect the order of the messages while storing them in the intermediate layer.
Kafka adds an offset to every message written to a partition. The order of messages is guaranteed within a partition, but not across the topic. All messages written to a partition by one producer are guaranteed to have the offsets in the same order as they were written by the producer. If a producer writes two messages to two different partitions, the second message could be committed faster than the first message. In such a scenario, the second message gets lower offset than the first message. Order is not guaranteed across the topic.
In this conversation, the architect wants to build an intermediate storage layer for the source messages, which is persistent, modular, supporting multiple message formats, reliable, physically distributed, supporting write strategies for consistency and performance, and guaranteeing the order of messages. He has spoken to the Kafka team and found out which features of Kafka can address these architectural needs. In the next videos, the conversation continues to discuss the architectural needs related to consuming the data streams and processing the events. and how Kafka supports those needs. Please subscribe the channel and click on bell icon to get an alert. Thank you for watching this video.